This is the Horse Radio Network.
This is episode 776 of Horse Tip Daily. A different horse tip, a different equine topic, a different equestrian expert every day. Horse Tip Daily brings the world of equine knowledge to you one day at a time. Today's tip is brought to you by Wintec Saddles, featuring the Easy Change Fit Solution. Hi, Coach Jen here, and thanks for tuning in to Horse Tip Daily. Today's tip is from the Dressage Radio Show, episode number 199. Dressage Radio Show co-hosts Reese Kofler-Stanfield and Philip Parks, joined by Glenn the Geek, will continue their list of Carl Hester's best, not just for dressage riders, tips. But first, let's hear from today's sponsor. Too many riders know the frustration that comes from their saddle not fitting or no longer fitting. Many hours and many more dollars are often spent trying to compensate for a poor fit or buying another saddle, only to have the same thing happen again months later. Enter the Easy Change Fit Solution, available on Wintec Easy Care saddles. By combining the Easy Change Gullet system introduced over 15 years ago with the new Easy Change Riser system, Wintec now offers an unparalleled scope of adjustment for a total fitting solution that's not only easy, but measurable, giving total confidence to be able to make changes to the saddle. Whether you're a serious competitor or ride horses for the sheer joy of it, choose a saddle with the Easy Change Fit solution that puts your horse's comfort first. Enjoy the peace of mind in knowing that your saddle offers full adjustability and is able to meet the changing needs of your horse. Find out more today at EasyChangeFitSolution.com.
Great. Well, Reese, would you like to go back to our list, or Carl Hester's list, I guess, and continue on with these tips? I think they're really helpful for me. It gave me something to think about, you know.
Yeah, I think so. Absolutely. So we did 1 through 10 last week, and so we're going to do 11 through 20 this week. So number 11, create a workstation on your yard or farm where everything to do with work happens. For example, tacking up and washing off, and keep a stable for relaxation only. Then your horse knows when he's totally relaxed and when he's in the stall and when he's expected to work. We have this at my barn. Philip, do you have that at your barn?
I mean, yeah, I've crossed eyes, right? I mean, right. I think with many indoor barns, that you're always going to have an area, right? I think it's just tough, yes, in the outdoor yards to sometimes you have to create an area. So we see this in England quite a bit, but not normally in North American issue. So what are we on? Number 12?
Number 12.
If your horse is too sensitive to the leg, work on lots of downwards transitions.
I like it. I think that's right.
Yeah, pretty much no-brainer, but a helpful tip anyways. You know, you don't want them running and going fast all the time. So.
Right. And I can say upward transitions too. I think horses that are sensitive to the leg need to have the leg put on them. And I think that's
feel it and be comfortable and not want to run away all the time. So, yeah.
Yeah. All right. Number 13, lots of transitions between canter and trot will help to improve the trot by getting him to carry more weight on his back end. Absolutely.
That's a good one. And when you think about it, you know, the canter is the gait, just the way that the mechanics of it work, that they have to sit on, you know, because they kind of rock a little bit back and forth. They have to sit on their hind leg a little bit. So, you know, you got to use the different gaits to improve. You can use the canter to improve the trot and sometimes the walk to improve the canter. You know, like you just mix them all up. Like, you know, if you feel that it's not right and you're working away, change the gait up. Do something a little bit different that way. And you might come back to the trot and feel that it improved it. But, you know, just this is another one on just transitions. Number 14, to maintain balance while you're working your horse, use lots of half halts. Think about using one before you ask your horse to do anything.
Absolutely. I mean, we can do a whole week show on just that statement.
Half halts. There's lots of different places to half halts. There's a little bit different ways to make half halts depending on what you're working on, but Yeah, the half halt's kind of like a mini transition. So again, another one about transitions and rebalancing the horse all the time.
I love it. You know, I just made a note because I think we should do a whole show on half halts. And we'll get a couple trainers on to describe half halts and what they mean, because we all hear half halt, half halt, half halt. You know, what does that mean? So we'll come back. I made a note, everybody. We'll revisit that on another show. But number 15, give your horse sugar during training sessions as a reward and to help him mouth the bit, which will encourage him to salivate and make him lighter in the hand.
You know, I normally give sugar when I'm bidding the horse, you know, but it doesn't hurt to have a cube in your pocket or something. We use sugar and mint sometimes. So, yeah, I think that's
good. And I use sugar too sometimes when I have a horse that's a little bit funny to get on. I think, actually, I learned that.
Big time, yeah. To make them wait and just, it's a training tool, right?
Yep, make them wait. And then you have to make sure that you have a sugar in your hand. But I don't always, once they sort of get better at it. So I guess I do this a little bit when getting on. So if I need to get them to stand still.
Number 16, riding your horse on and back involves asking him for a few lengthened strides before asking him to come back to his working pace, then repeating it several times. This is what will help you to get him to carry his head and neck and achieve self-carriage. This is about, and transitions within the gate, right? We talk about transitions, walk, trot, canter. We talk about half halts. And then this is, again, going back to transitions to, you know, small gait, big gait, little lengthening. You know, even the young horses, even though we don't ask them to extend or really collect, you're doing tons of a little forward, a little back, playing with the gait, keeping the horse interested. We do this all the time. It's really helpful.
Yeah, very helpful. Okay, number 17. When doing tempi changes, a series of flying change, with more advanced horses, we ride along the wall of the arena to help keep the horse straight.
From a basic thing to this is a more complex thing, but it's very important when you're doing flying changes, you know, dressage-wise, to do them on, to be able to do them on a very straight line. That's keeps the horse jumping through, not losing balance side to side as you're going, you know, back and forth. But even that one change, you know, I think before I even start tempi changes, I make sure that I'm able to do a flying change down the long side and use the wall a little bit. Straightness is so important in the changes.
Agreed. No, I think, you know, you need, I do them on the wall. I do them on the circle. So many of us see on the test where you go on the diagonal and you ride 5.4s, you ride 5.3s, but you need to be able to do them in different places.
All over the arena, the test.
All over.
And you ask different questions. So, if you're practicing away the third level test and, you know, I think the change is almost always on the diagonal. But when you're training, train it in different places, right?
Yep.
That stops the horse from anticipating the change a little bit and can make the whole idea more relaxed. Number 18. With a horse who is trained to do collected canter, you want to aim for a speed where someone can walk alongside you.
Huh. I never thought about it that way. Carl's so my hero.
It depends on who's walking, right?
And how fast they're walking. Well, and on a Grand Prix horse, you should be able to do that. I've never tried it, but I think that's a new goal for my Denali, that someday he can canter with someone walking next to him, not running at full speed ahead. That's interesting. I've never thought about it that way, but I like the idea.
It's an interesting idea. I think, you know.
It's got to be a pretty trained horse.
You get the horse a little bit backwards if you do this too much. But,
that's
got to
be a trained horse.
Doing collected canter that you want to, you know, before you, when you make collected canter to walk, you want to be covering just as much ground in the canter as you would in the walk, and then you can have a nice transition. I think that's how I really approach the collected canter and getting that idea that maybe not someone, but at least another horse could walk alongside you and cover the same amount of ground.
Right. No, I like it. So number 19, use leg yields in the canter to make your horse move more aware of your legs. I do this myself. I actually went to a wonderful clinic in Louisville and taught this weekend. And I use this a couple times on a couple different horses to get them a little more off the inside leg. But also a couple of them were crooked. So it's a good exercise for that. So it's a good exercise.
I see that a lot is horses that like to carry in the, you know, kind of only in the canter, that their hind leg a little bit in front of their foreleg, like a little in travers instead of shoulder in, right? So you start with a little leg yield, just like in trot. You start with a little leg yield to teach the horse shoulder in, so eventually the horse will be able to shoulder in canter properly with the hind leg underneath and pushing the wither up and all that wonderful stuff. So I use that on straight lines, but also on the circles to be able to actually leg yield into the circle and canter a little bit. That helps the horse not lean so much, you know, on the smaller circles and get the balance better. So lots of leg yield and canter. It's perfect. Where are we at here? Number 20. Mm-hmm. To help you maintain the rhythm while riding, keep a song in your head and sing it to yourself while you ride. It's a good idea.
I like it. I like it a lot. Yeah. And I in my indoor, you know, now I put up a sound system and I tell you, I really like it. I find myself, it keeps me a little bit more engaged. And by horse number 5, when I'm in there by myself, I like it. And I like the music. Great. So yeah, I think there's the radio a lot on. To it.
Get the music going a little bit. And it helps everybody stay a little bit more relaxed. But
and the sports psychologists say that you should have your own song. So when the stress comes on about showtime and you're getting tacked up and you're riding your warm up, everybody should have their own song. That's their go-to place, and they should sing it to themselves when they're super stressed out, especially on show day.
Reese, what's your song?
Yeah. So
what would you pick as your song?
And what would I pick as my song?
It's interesting that he said that, because it should be one that you can get a rhythm to. It's not only anti-stress, but it also helps get in the rhythm, literally.
I'm going to pick Staying Alive.
Yeah.
That's a good one, actually.
I like that. I like that.
Yeah. Yeah, because it does have a good rhythm, a good beat to it.
It's got an excellent rhythm. Yeah.
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 Yeah. And it has a good message, too.
Yeah, exactly.
I know. Yeah, exactly.
It's more of an inventor song, though, I would think, yeah. Staying Alive.
That's true.
And that's a wrap. If you enjoyed Reese, Philip, and Glenn chatting about all things dressage, you can tune in every week at dressageradio.com. You can also find lots more tips about becoming a better rider at horsetipdaily.com. Just look for the topics drop-down menu on the left. Don't forget to support our sponsors here on Horse Tip Daily, because they make these podcasts possible, and they also make some pretty awesome saddles. Today's tip has been brought to you by Wintec Saddles, featuring the Easy Change Fit Solution. Please stop by the Horse Tip Daily Facebook page and let us know what you think of the tips you hear on the show. It's also a great place to tell us about topics you'd like to hear us cover on the show. You can subscribe to all the great shows on the Horse Radio Network through iTunes or Zune and get your horse podcasts automatically downloaded to your iPod, Zune, or MP3 player. You can also listen to the shows right on Facebook. The player's right there every day. I'll be back again tomorrow with another new expert and a different horse tip. Until then, go ride your horse! The Horse Radio Network and the Horse Radio Network hosts are not responsible for statements of guests or their opinions. Use your own judgment when listening to the tips provided by the experts on Horse Tip Daily.